Hello students, welcome to IBPS Guide YouTube channel. Today we will discuss antonyms. Yesterday we discussed synonyms of LIC AAO exam, and today we will discuss antonyms of LIC AAO exams. You know that antonyms means the opposite word. We will get an option, we will get a word, and we get 5 options. And among them, we have to choose the correct antonyms. So, antonyms is opposite words. So, without wasting time, we can start our class. Let's move to question number 1. Directions 1 to 10. Given below is a passage or words. You have to read the questions and choose the options which is antonyms or opposite in meaning in the word given the questions. My dear students, for LIC AAO exams, this type of words are very, very important. These 10 words are very, very important, and we also get the 5 options on this, and I will tell you the each and every meaning of this word. So you can easily locate, and you can easily read, and you can easily remember of each and every words, the meaning of each and every words. Tomorrow also, yesterday also, I told you that if you want to remember vocabs, you have to go through the root words, and that is etymology. Each and every words has root words. If I get time, I will definitely give a class to you, that is the root words and etymology, how to remember the vocabularies. Whatever may be, today we will discuss this type of words, and each and every options we will discuss, and each and every words, the meaning of these words we will also discuss, taki you are very much clear, and you are very much, it will be very much easy for you to locate the antonyms or opposite words. So remember it, that today we will discuss antonyms. This is not the synonymous word. This is the antonyms, means opposite word. So let's move to question number 1. That is the first options, first word is adversary. First word, we get the first word, that is adversary. What's the meaning of adversary? The meaning of adversary means that is oppose or resist. And we get 5 options. First option is boorish. Second option, chaos. Third option, accomplish. Fourth option, enemy. Fifth option, child. So what's the meaning of boorish? Boorish means resembling or befitting a rude person. Resembling or befitting a rude person, like that rude person who can be the person who is very much rude, the resembling with someone, that is called boorish. Resembling or befitting a rude person. Second option is chaos. Chaos means complete confusion. Complete confusion. Third is accomplish. Accomplish means a person who works with, or we also can say that help someone of doing illegal. Okay. Third, fourth option, enemy. You know that. What do you mean by enemy? Enemy means rival. And fifth option is chide. Chide means to express mild disapproval. We can write that to express mild disapproval. Also, we can say that scold. So we get the 5 options, and we get the meaning of these 5 words also. So what will be the opposite word of adversary? Adversary means oppose and resist. सो अपोज करना, रेजिस्ट करना, दैट इज कॉल्ड एडवर्सरी. सो वट कैन बी द ऑपोजिट वर्ड ऑफ एडवर्सरी? इट विल बी अकॉम्प्लिश. अ पर्सन हु वर्क्स विथ, अ पर्सन हु अपोज देयर द एडवर्सरी, अ पर्सन हु वर्क्स विथ और हेल्प सम वन, दैट इज कॉल्ड अकॉम्प्लिश. सो एब्सोल्यूट एंटोनिम्स वर्ड, एब्सोल्यूट ऑपोजिट वर्ड ऑफ एडवर्सरी इज अकॉम्प्लिश. आंसर विल बी सी. Option number two, that is affable. Second words, that is second word, it is affable. Affable means friendly and easy to talk. And easy to talk. Friendly and easy to talk, that means affable. First option, pandemonium. Pandemonium means pandemonium is a capital of hell. You know that John Milton's Paradise Lost, the poet John Milton's was wrote Paradise Lost, and in Paradise Lost there was a word that is pandemonium, and pandemonium means that is a capital of hell. So from that point of view, pandemonium means the evil spirit, which is not good, which is not better for us, that is evil spirit, and is a capital of hell in Milton's Paradise Lost. So this is called pandemonium. Pandemonium is absolutely negative word. Affable is a positive word and pandemonium is negative word. So pandemonium means, that is the pandemonium words, we could locate it from the capital, the capital of hell, the capital of hell in Milton's Paradise Lost. So we can say that evil spirit, evil spirit, pandemonium. Next word is brusque. Brusque means that is talking or behaving in a very directly, talking or behaving in a very direct manner, in a very direct manner. Fourth option, third option is eradicate. Eradicate means completely remove, yeah, to remove. Fourth option is cordial. Cordial means politely, pleasant and friendly. Politely, pleasant and friendly. And fifth option is ally. Ally means to join with another person, to join with another person. So affable means friendly and easy to talk. Pandemonium, that is evil spirit. Brusque, talking or behaving in a very direct manner, very rude manner, we can also say that, very rude manner. And eradicate, completely remove. Cordial, politely, pleasant and friendly manner. Ally, to join with another person. So guys, I hope it is clear to you which will be the opposite word of affable. That will be C. That will be brusque. The antonyms of affable is brusque. Let's go to second, third words. Third word is jaunty. Third word means jaunty. Jaunty means, what is the meaning of jaunty? Jaunty means lively in manner. Those who are lively in manner. Or appearance. Very lively person, very lively mannerial person, they are called jaunty. First option is somber. Somber means very sad and sorrow. Second word, cajole. Cajole means to deceive with something words, something in soothing words, to deceive with to deceive with, soothing words. Third option is entice. Entice means to attract. Fourth word is inveigle. Inveigle means to get something in a clever or deceptive way. To get something in a clever or deceptive way. And fifth option is amiable. Amiable means friendly and pleasant person. Friendly and pleasant. So, which can be the opposite word of jaunty? Those who are very lively in manner. Opposite word, somber. Those who are very sad and very much sorrow and very morose person, very serious person. We can also that very sad and sorrow and very serious person are called somber. So opposite word of jaunty is, antonyms of jaunty is somber. Next word, that is lucid. Lucid, what's the meaning of lucid? Lucid meaning very clear and easy to understand, which is very clear to us, very clear and easy to understand, and easy to understand, that is called lucid. First option is replica. Replica means to exact or very close copy of something. We can say that to exact or very close copy of something. Second option is dexterous. Dexterous means that is having and showing great skill. Those who have shown very great skill. So we can say that having or showing great skill or cleverness. Third option is barrel. Barrel kya hai? What is a barrel? Barrel is a round, usually wooden container. D option, abstruse. Abstruse means difficult to comprehend. Difficult to comprehend. And E, skillful. Everybody knows that. What is the meaning of skillful? Skillful means experienced, having some training, knowledge, experience that is needed to do something well. So we can write that having the training, knowledge and experience. That is needed to do something well. So which can be the opposite word of lucid? Lucid means very clear. So opposite word is abstruse, difficult to comprehend. So absolute antonyms word, opposite word is D. Our answer will be D. Let's move to question number 5. Option number 5th is morose. Morose means very sad or unhappy. Very sad or unhappy. First option, raillery. What do you mean by raillery? Raillery means friendly joking. Friendly joking. Joking about, we can say that, with somebody or with somebody. Second option is blith. Blith means not caring. Not caring or worrying. Not caring or worrying. So morose means very sad or very unhappy, or blith means not caring or not worrying. Whatever you can think that you can always tell him without any care, very carelessly talking, that is called blith. And raillery, friendly joking about or with somebody. Third option is chaff. That is something comparatively worthless. Is meaning the meaning of chaff is something comparatively worthless. Baton. Baton means a thick wooden stick. A thick wooden stick that is used for music conductor. So we can write that a thin stick. That is used by a music conductor. And erupt, to happen or begin suddenly. Erupt means to happen or begin suddenly. Violently, we can also write that. Suddenly begin violently or suddenly. So which can be the opposite word of morose? Morose, that is blith. Not caring, not worrying, that is called blith. So opposite word of, the antonyms of morose is blith. Next word, shallow. Shallow, that is any of several old world bored. We can write that any of several old world bored. First option is opaque. Opaque means not letting light through. Not letting light through. That is called opaque. Second option, emulsified. Emulsified means to mix together. To mix together. Mix together to form an emulsion. Mix together to form an emulsion. Third option is sable. Sable means a small animal. A small animal has soft brown hair. We also can say that a small animal has soft brown fur. Fourth option, abstruse. Very difficult to comprehend. Difficult to comprehend. And florid, very fancy. Florid means very fancy. So any of several old world bored, that is opposite word, which can be the opposite word, several old world bored, very old, which is very old, the opposite word of shallow is, that is florid. Okay, so old and fancy. Question number 7th. Next is platitude. Platitude means a statement that express an idea that is not new, and a statement that expresses an idea that is not new. First option is truism. Truism means a true statement. A true statement that is very commonly heard. That is very commonly heard. Second option is relinquish, to give up. To give up. Third option is perfunctory, means used to describe something. Used to describe something that is done without energy. That is done without energy. Fourth option is beret. Beret means done to yell at. We can say that to yell at. To yell at. And fifth option is revile, to speak about. We can say that to speak about. So platitude, a statement is not new, it's very old and commonly heard. The statement is commonly heard, that is the antonyms word of, opposite word of platitude. So answer will be truism. Earth, that is zenith. Zenith means the strongest or highest point. The strongest or most successful period of time, successful period of point. So most successful period of time. First option is acme. Acme means the highest point. Second option is shrew. Shrew means that is a small animal. A small animal that looks like a mouse. Very unpleasant and bad tempered women is also called shrewd. Third option is nadir. Nadir means lowest point. Lowest point of something. And fourth option is cumulation. To end, cumulation. Sorry, culmination. Extremely sorry. Culmination. Culmination means to end or final result of something. And fifth option is shallow. Shallow means having a small distance to the bottom from the space. It is the highest point. So we can write that having a small distance to the bottom from the space. So the antonyms word of zenith is nadir, highest point, lowest point. Word number ninth is banal. Banal means ordinary. First option is benevolent. Benevolent means kind and generous person. Second option is avidity. Avidity means keen, eagerness. Third option is genuine, actual and real. Third option is bogus, not real or genuine. Not real or genuine. Vivid, very clear. Very bright in color. Very bright in color. So banal, that is very ordinary, which is dull, pale, and very bright, that is vivid. So opposite word will be, antonyms will be vivid, that is E. Last word is clandestine. Clandestine supply of arms. Clandestine means done secretly. First option is collaboration. To work with another person. Collaboration is a very common word. To work with another person. Second option is conniving. Conniving means, there is a conniving. Conniving means to secretly help someone. To secretly help someone. Third option is surreptitious. Surreptitious means done in a secret way. Done in a secret way. Fourth option is manifest. Able to be seen. Able to be seen. Or ample. Ample means quite large. So clandestine means secretly done, and opposite word will be manifest, able to be seen. So that's why antonyms will be D. Dear students, I hope it is clear to you. Very simple word, very common word also. Lot of words are very easy to you, and lot of words is very common to you, and lot of words are uncommon for you. So I hope this session is helpful for you, and please this 10 words and with five options of antonyms, five option of synonyms are very much helpful for you, specifically for LIC AAO exams. So keep it a practice and try to remember this. And again, I will say you that do it root words and go through the etymology. Etymology and root words will be very much helpful for remembering the vocabularies. Thank you. Have a fine day.